Hey guys, I'm on my way to the first ever Starbucks Reserve. So this actually just opened up this morning. It's the opening morning. It's 7 a.m. And literally this place just popped up overnight. I live only a block away, but I was passing by it last night and I was like, oh my God, this looks insane. I was really excited about this and I'm pretty excited to check it out. I don't know too much about their selection and stuff, but we'll figure it out. Just bear with me here. Already the interior looks really sweet. It almost looks like a mixture of a brewery and a distillery kind of thing. So we'll come in here so you can see the it's called the Starbucks Reserve Roastery and Tasting Room. So interesting, they're going with this different placement, you know, like nice golden star and R. So they have their own. So this is interesting. So it's a roastery, but then there's also I don't know if you could make it out, but a Serious Pie, which is a really good Tom Douglas restaurant in the area. So that's really exciting. I didn't actually know that, but I'm guessing they combine like some food with Starbucks. Free Wi-Fi from our friends at Google. That's pretty sweet. I've never seen actual branding of that type before, but yeah, that's really cool. So let's come in, see how heavy these doors are. Not that heavy. Seen heavier doors. Actually, I just noticed something over here. Let's see what this is. Looks like a little copper dog thing, which is cool. Nice little touch there. Okay, continuing in. Sorry for that little detour. So let's see. First impressions, it's a really big space. Pretty huge space. We got some music going on already. I smell the roasting of some coffee beans. Let's see, we have some Starbucks. Copper is a theme with these guys here, which already, you know, like it promotes really the elegance of the brand. Sorry, like that came off as pretty pretentious, but sorry. So we got some coffee cups. Looks like this is the Serious Pie. Not open right now because it's 7 a.m., but here's the brick oven over there, if you can see in the back. So brick oven pizza. We got some of the Nuove espresso, French press machines. So some nice stuff. Personal fan of the glossy one. This one kind of looks a little bit 70s, 80s, maybe not like 90s style to me, but cool stuff overall. Looks like we have a bar over here. Starbucks with a bar. Pretty sweet. So a bar, I see some wines. Let's see what beers are on tap. We got, let me see if I can get in here and see. It's got Odin. More local stuff. Field 41, Odin. We got some Stoop up in Ballard. And then interesting root beer on tap. That's pretty cool. Don't see any Germans, which are my personal favorite, but I'll probably put in a request with them. Hopefully, Tom Douglas restaurants are usually pretty open to requests for stuff like that, so hopefully they will take it. And you got the Serious Pie logo. Always thought this guy's a little bit weird. There's the appendage coming out of the bottom with like that flame over it. Like I'm not. I won't go there. Okay. But yeah, you got the menu there, Serious Pie menu. Take a screen cap of this if you want to read it. Okay. Okay, so we have some more weighing coffee machines, it looks like. I don't know if these are functional or just, these might be just for show. They might be just older machines for show. Or they might be, it looks like that this is actually something that can be used for tastings. So more of a tasting. Excuse me? Is this a tasting space? Or?
This is a scoop table.
So how does it work?
So we scoop any fresh coffee right here.
Oh, awesome. And is it the normal Starbucks variety? Or?
It's all reserved coffees.
Okay.
We only serve coffees that are roasted here in-house.
Oh, so wait, here, like in this location?
Yeah, right here.
Okay, awesome. Awesome. They smell good. Okay, thanks a lot.
Yeah.
Yep. Did you try anything yet? Or okay, but it was a cool. What's your opinions on the place so far?
I think this place is amazing.
Yeah, got up at 7 a.m. for it, right? So. What? Sorry.
I get up at
5. Even on the weekends.
1-year-olds don't know it's a weekend.
I gotcha. But did you? You didn't take them with you though.
No, this is my time.
Oh yeah, and caffeine's not good for. I mean, you could go decaf though, right? Heavy on the milk. Yeah. They probably don't like the taste though. Right. Have a nice day. Have a nice day. This thing kind of reminds me of a freight train. Not sure what. So what is this that we're looking at here?
Right now, I'm noticing some of the Sumatra light-tailed blueberry.
Okay, awesome. This is like has this been used before? Like, this is all brand new, this stuff, or?
Oh, yeah, I've been using it for a couple months, breaking it in.
Okay, sweet.
Doing some testing. Yeah.
So how long has this spot been, like, because I live only a block away, but I didn't, like, see this here until, like, last night. Has it been here? Like, it's
we opened yesterday. It's been under construction for a year.
Okay. Awesome. Thanks a lot. It's really exciting. As someone that lives like a block away, like I'm really excited.
I'm 2 blocks up the hill. I can relate.
So my thing now is like a date idea is basically like find a girl, ask her to coffee. Yeah. She'll be like, where you want to go? Say Starbucks, which normally like, and it's not a swipe at Starbucks or anything, but right, like
you want something a little bit kitschy, unique, and old.
And then you show up here. I think that would be awesome.
Yeah. And plus there's dinner right over there too.
Yeah, you got the Tom Douglas Sears pie, right? That's cool. All right, thanks a lot. Okay, so we'll look at the kind of the pastry selection. Got some pastries over here. Is that a pretzel bagel? The pretzel bagel is awesome. Pretzel bagels, some crumpets. Oh, sorry, biscuits. I was in the UK recently, so I'm kind of still channeling that. That's actually why I've been waking up so early, because I've been in the UK for work lately. So my normal wake up time lately has been like 4:30 a.m., which is not proud about that, but I'm trying to work on it. Basically, drinking Red Bulls to stay up at night, and it's a losing battle. But like, I basically talked the guy at the local cafe into giving me a Red Bull discount because I've been buying so many lately. So, we'll see if that works out.
Are you making a video for somebody?
It's just for the internet. Like, there's a lot of people. Like, this is the first one.
I know. Yeah.
So, can I use your likeness? Like, are you okay with, like, showing up in it?
Oh, yeah, totally.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, you look great. Let's get a close-up on your face. You look great.
I have 2 young kids. Like I said, I wake up between 4:30 and 5 every day.
Yeah. So. Okay. Hey, for 4:30 and 5, like, yeah. Like, you should be very happy with yourself.
And they were up all night long, too.
Yep. Oh, that sucks.
Yeah, it does suck.
Like, all night? How do they stay up all night and then, like...
No, they wake up through the night. So I have a 1-year-old and an almost 3-year-old.
Okay.
And the 1-year-old is still breastfeeding, so she'll wake up, like, every 3 hours to nurse. And then the other
and
one...
And you have to be ready for that?
You have to wake up and feed them.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah, that's
like, middle of the night? That's weird.
Okay.
That's weird. What are we seeing? What are we seeing here?
Pictures of the kids.
Is it safe for YouTube?
Sure.
Okay.
So that's the 1-year-old.
What's his name?
That's Maisie. She's a girl.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay. Yeah. She's the one that wakes up throughout the night.
Okay.
She's eating broccoli there.
Wait, and she eats broccoli already?
Yeah, they start eating around 6-7 months.
They're probably that period where like broccoli is just food. And then it'll become
exactly.
A bad thing. It's weird. Like, the relationship with broccoli is kind of like, it's like maybe you like it, and then it goes down. And then like you, like 18, 19, nah, maybe a little bit earlier, right? Like it becomes all right.
Yeah.
But
so we actually came yesterday.
Oh, I thought today was the opening.
No, yesterday. It was very crazy.
Oh, I didn't make it for the opening. Yeah. Damn it.
It was packed. I don't know if you can...
Let's do this phone inception.
Probably not very good. The line was basically to there.
To where? To where over here?
To where that guy is with the security.
The Allied Barton guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, I gotcha. Yeah, I came by last night and there were security guards outside and they told me like 7 a.m. opening tomorrow. I thought that was a grand opening, but...
So it was yesterday. They had like a film crew over there right in front of that bar.
Okay, so people already have footage.
And Howard Schultz was here and gave a speech.
Wait, Howard... Damn it, I missed Howard Schultz. I would love to see him.
So where, what YouTube channel is this going to be on?
I have
to... Do you have a username?
Yeah, it's, it's I-I-M-S-M-A-R-T-I-I.
I have to send myself an email.
Okay.
Okay, I-I...
M...
M...
Smart... S-M-A-R-T...
I-I...
Smart, like intelligent? Smart.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. It's my fingers.
Oh.
Okay, is that it?
I-I... I-I after
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I think... I-I... So, I am smart, I-I...
My last name's Smart. It's not like it's not like saying I am smart or something like that.
So that's two I's. It looks like an L on here.
Yeah, it's that's the problem, and I regret it, but I think that's how I created it. Oh, no, actually, no, it's not. Sorry, it's not just that. I'll find it after I finish the broadcast and give it to you. Cause
I'm leaving in like 2 minutes.
I can find it in a minute 30.
Funny pass, because as soon as
I can't do it. The thing is, I can't film and do that at the same time.
Facebook?
Yeah, Michael Smart. That's
there's probably a million of you.
No, there's not. There's really not that many. And I'm like, not to sound, I won't go there, but in the Seattle area, I've done a search.
Are
you
a partner manager
at
Microsoft?
Yeah. Yeah, that's me.
Is it okay if I add you? You can always defriend me later, but.
I won't defriend you unless you post a lot of spam stuff. So.
Or
if you invite me to Candy Crush, I'll immediately unfriend you.
I've
so.
Had a lot of Starbucks Facebook
ones. Oh, really?
Yeah, for trading cards. So hokey.
Oh, the gift cards? I have a friend.
Why I'm here to buy a couple
of cards. Do they have a limited edition here? Oh, awesome.
Come on, don't you know these things?
No, but my friend Julia will really like this.
Oh, no, totally get along.
She collects them.
Yeah, I collect them too.
Is it a limited time thing, or they'll have it whenever?
I would get her one now. I mean, what difference is that?
Yeah.
Because it's the first edition.
You could put like $5 on it or something.
Yeah. Right, well, I'm cool. Gonna get 50 of them so I can trade them.
50?
And then I have to take all the money off. It's
fine. Wait, how does that work?
I'm gonna get 50 gift cards with $5 in each, and then I have to go. Hi there, I was gonna get some gift cards.
Yeah.
Interesting. We have a gift card collector and buyer slash mother slash slash breastfeeder at all hours of the morning. Impressive individual right here at 7 a.m. for the opening. I gotta check out the menu. All right. Wow, that's really bright. Okay, so the espresso macchiato. You got the calorie listings there. I'm more of a latte kind of guy. Let's see what the specials are. So they have the interesting. Some roastery exclusives. So I'm probably gonna try an exclusive. Americano crema, ice swirling espresso with mint, shakerito bianco. Again, with these things, if you guys are interested in reading them, just take a screen cap or something of the video. So let's go through this. You know what? I'm gonna go through this whole thing, and I'm gonna do what I usually do at restaurants: ask for their recommendation. Because it's just too many options that I can't really select one. Also, it's very early in the morning and I haven't had my coffee yet, so it's kind of like a chicken before the egg problem. Selecting coffee before you're coherent enough to read a coffee menu. Some of my jokes are fails, so just like letting everyone know that. Oh my god. You could just buy the whole box and they could just give it to you in the box. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is it possible that you could put 200
on one and maybe?
Instead of scanning
50,
could you just put 250 on one and maybe the others on the
Efficiency. I like it.
Efficiency.
Let's see if this barista can. I don't know if they call them baristas here, but let's see if he could.
He's
a coffee master. Let's see if he could deal with this situation that's being presented to him. We have an agreement that it would be faster. Now, does the back end system allow that? That's what we're gonna have to get into as far as so he's dealing. He may have been a blackjack dealer in his previous life. because it seems like he's dealing nicely. So he's counting them right now. Okay.
Nice. Good.
Got some Evolution, Pellegrino, Ethos Water, Ethos. I'm not sure. I don't know my Greek that well. Okay. Got some more people coming in now that we're open here. That looks like it's someone on my soccer team, but I think it's just a lookalike. So one suggestion that I do have for this place is if they're able to operate to, because they have the set, the... On what, sorry? Oh. Are you guys okay with it? It's just YouTube. Oh, okay, yeah. And I didn't really get you guys. Like, I just kind of, like, moved. It was very fast. With the motion blur, it probably wasn't, like...
It would have been so prevalent if I hadn't thought of that myself.
Okay, no, I totally appreciate it.
Yeah,
I gotcha. I've done stuff like that before. Like, I like recording everything, so... You have to be careful sometimes. I'm sorry. Yeah, sorry if you were offended or something. So, so my suggestion for this would be to, and it looks like she might be doing that right now, just to open the second one. So, yeah. Look at this transaction amount, $155. Starbucks, if you're seeing this movie, what's your name?
My name's Jen. I collect Starbucks cards.
Her name is Jen, and she collects Starbucks cards. So if you need, like, a Jared from Subway representative, I think Jen would be great. Like, she seems like a good mother and, like, very, very interesting person. Yeah, I'll try to avoid getting other people from now on other than the Starbucks employees, because the employees did allow me, but I just need to be careful with the other people. The bags are nice, too?
Yes! We're knowing so much about this store, I'm surprised you don't know about
it. I don't know much, I'm learning. It's a learning process.
Is it okay to take a menu?
So we noticed this copper over here.
Or this paper thing?
Oh, yes.
So my first impression when I came in here was, if anyone's been to Ghent in Belgium, one of my favorite cities, the Parquise restaurant. Yeah, nice to meet you. The Parquise restaurant in Ghent has a similar interior. Very, very good. What would you recommend as far as, like, something unique to, like, this Starbucks
Absolutely.
Location?
There are a lot of good stuff. I would recommend the sparkling espresso with mint.
Sparkling espresso with mint. I'll do that. And can I get a $5 gift card also?
Absolutely.
Sweet.
What type of espresso would you like in your...
Single shot.
Sure, but no, we actually have four different types of espresso.
Okay.
I would recommend the Pantheon. It's a blend that we only have here at the Roastery. Is that right?
Yeah. Okay. I'm very much a Yelper. Like, I just go with whatever's the highest rated,
absolutely.
Usually. Well, highest rated and then number of reviews.
Sure.
But, yeah.
So, the gift card this morning?
Yeah.
What dollar amount would you like?
$5, please.
Sure, absolutely. Do you like any breakfast or anything else today?
I'm good for today.
Okay.
But I live down the block, so I'll probably come back.
Yeah, no worries. Well, we hope that you do. And may, awesome. What is your name, sir?
I'm Michael.
Michael?
Yep.
Good to meet you.
Yeah, you too. What's your name?
Greg?
Oh, Greg. I think you already said that. Sorry.
No worries.
Greg from Indianapolis.
It's true.
Are you a Colts? Are you a Colts fan?
Not necessarily. I don't dislike them. But,
that's cool, because I'm a Patriots fan, so I like it a little bit better already.
All right. There's that for you, sir.
All right.
We'll call out your name, your beverage. Just at the center of the bar as soon as we have it ready.
Okay. Awesome. So now we got someone making. So you notice it's all Nuova Simonelli machines. Let's see what's over here. Who's that?
Greg.
Oh, Greg, okay. How's the food?
I don't know yet.
Oh, okay. I'll get back to you guys. You got a nice biscuit there, though. Is that butter or is that...
Honey butter,
interesting. Okay, very cool. This copper thing must have cost a ton of money. Wow. I don't know how... Wow, that's, like, enormous. I know that, like, Hey, I forgot to say hi. That was awkward. Some if you guys are familiar with like lambic beer, it basically like ferments with, this is like a history lesson for like beer people, but lambic beer actually ferments in certain locations that yeast's built up, and they don't put any yeast into it, it's just from the environment. So when I was in Bruges, I basically was able to go to one of the traditional lambic breweries, and what they have is basically like a huge copper surface that they pour the wort onto it, and then like it ferments overnight. And they could only do it in that room because it's like a very special blend of yeast that's developed over the years. So anyways, that was like, to make a long story short, like that was the largest copper instrumentation I had seen so far. I'm not sure if like the LHC or anything is copper, but I didn't see that in person anyway. So you basically have this thing. This is like enormous. It's really cool, like a centerpiece for the place. And then I'm not going to go down here because I think my coffee's almost ready, but it looks like there's some more stuff. Looks like a Wi-Fi meeting space down there. Some other like interesting kitchen style setup over there. Okay. Yeah, I have to say that, and I don't work for Starbucks or anything, but like so far everyone's been really nice. Like great first impression. Look at this. Trays, mugs, like it's clear where you need to. It's a Seattle thing in general, but we have the compost and recycle. Look at this, first one to use their compost, receptacle. That's an honor. Okay. All right, let's see if we're ready. So this was actually served. This is nice. Like this, and it's not that I'm not a normal Starbucks fan, but like, you know, there's a lot of people have been saying like you need. Like, there's a changing landscape in terms of coffee places. So one of my other favorite coffee places in Seattle, Moore Coffee House, they do a lot with, like, the latte art and stuff like that. And, like, just putting in that extra level of effort to me is really big in terms of a coffee shop. And it looks like they're doing that here. So that's good to see. That's really good to see. So kept you guys already for 22 minutes, but hopefully we'll get the coffee soon, and then I'll be able to taste it and just give my first impression. And I have to admit, like, I'm actually not a big coffee connoisseur. Like, talk to me about beer or whiskey, like, I got that down. Coffee, I admittedly don't know that much. Like, the Trader Joe's is, like, pretty good. I get some of their blends. But, yeah, I just have, like, a Mr. Coffee machine at home. Haven't invested in anything bigger yet. We got a scone delivery. No, I'm not Chris, but... it's a nice scone. Okay. Would you guys want to be on camera for a YouTube thing, or? How's the coffee in your opinion? Interesting latte art we got here. Is that latte, or?
It is. Yeah, no, it's stronger than I'm used to, so.
Yeah, it's a new thing, right? It's like a new, it's Starbucks in the next century. But it's actually older styling, so it's like interesting. Yeah, I'm really excited about this space. Like everything is like, ooh, you know? All right, thanks a lot, guys. Enjoy your coffee. Yep.
Thank you.
I actually don't know how big my phone's hard drive is. I've never taken a video this long, so hopefully it'll last till the coffee. Might need this countdown timer. And I hope this video like came out. Like I've done stuff before where I record it and like it just totally like doesn't record. So like if that didn't help, like it's ingrained in my mind. But like sorry for everyone else that wanted to get that was interested in this. I'm mainly doing this for like I have a lot of Starbucks. I have friends that work at Starbucks, both at a corporate and a barista or retail level, just across the country. So, kind of excited to share this with them on Facebook, and you know. And also, I just like kind of like checking out new stuff. Let's see, they even have like an old movie style sign up here. It's the small touches like this that really do it for me. Farmer's notes, farm rebuilt after 1962 volcano. So now I want to read that up on Wikipedia, like the Bella Vista, like what is that? Like some kind of volcano, like did they know about it? Why didn't they, like, did they just wait it out on the farm? Was it slash and burn, or, lava and burn farm? No, it would be, slash and, lava. Magma? No, lava, yeah. Slash and lava. Lava flow thing. I'll stop that joke now, sorry. Oh, yeah. That was the yeah, okay. Can you move that over to the other side? Sorry. I only have one hand. Okay, so any updated opinion? Updated opinion on the... Nice. So yeah, that's our endorsement right here. Order this when you get here. It's the biscuit. Okay. There is nothing like a dream to create the future. Victor Hugo, interesting. Interesting quote. Okay, so I feel like I'm about to drink a beer or like an Arnold Palmer or something. Actually, yeah, Arnold Palmer. Okay. Do you mix the sparkling water? Do you know how to drink this? Like, do you mix the sparkling water in with it or? Yeah, I've never seen this. Excuse me. How do you drink this drink?
You can drink it with a straw, without a straw.
But do you mix the sparkling into it?
No, the sparkling water is just kind of like an aperitif to kind of clean off your tongue.
Oh, before or like after?
Either.
Okay. Yeah. All right, cool. Thanks a lot. So I'm going with the aperitif before because I just brushed my teeth, so I kind of need to cleanse the palate a little bit. Okay. I'm not a big sparkling water fan. Generally, I prefer sweetened, but it's fine. Not like anything wrong that they did or anything. Okay, let's try it. It's very interesting. And when I say interesting, I don't mean like interesting in a bad way, because sometimes that can be perceived like that. I think it's a drink that will take some time to warm up on you. So it's like a mixture of an iced coffee with... take another one. Well, I got a mint leaf in that one. It's like an iced coffee mojito. That's the best I could describe it. It's good though. Like I like the little, like the color of the foam on top. Yeah, I like it. And then let's end this video with this little cookie. Let's see, it looks almost like a... Honestly, I won't even take a guess because I have no idea. So, cookie. Cookie's good, coffee's good, I'm probably going to put some sugar into it after I finish this video, or honey if they have it, I'm more of a honey guy, but yeah, I just want to say thanks to Starbucks for opening this awesome place next to my house. We got some action going on up there, and let's use that as a fade out. It's the Starbucks Reserve Roastery and Tasting Room, and today they're roasting something. The micro blend number 11. So everyone come down for the micro blend number 11. All right, this is Michael signing off. Thanks, guys.